Pretties, we put together a tutorial to show you how super fun and easy the bubble overlays are to use. So let's go ahead and take a look here and see how they're applied to an image. I have this cute image open of a baby in a field, and I want to add some bubbles to this image. So what I'm going to do is use my Pretty Actions bubble applicator. Okay, I have that open here in my actions panel. If you don't have it, just click on this little menu bar at the top of your actions panel and click load actions, okay? Okay, so I'm gonna select Pretty Bubble Applicator and press play. And now you'll wanna navigate to where you have your bubbles saved on your computer. Okay, you can see you have the large bubbles, the bonus sun specs, teeny tiny bubbles, followed by tiny bubbles. And I'm going to first apply tiny bubbles 28, press place. Okay, now here's where you can kind of move it around, shift click and drag to resize and still keep the proportion. And then just press enter when you're done and voila. Okay, it applies to your image like magic, looks beautiful and just blends right into your image there. Now, I actually wanted to give this an extra whimsical feel and just add a lot of bubbles. To do that, there are overlays with a lot of bubbles in them, but just to make it a little bit more fun, I'm going to add a couple more overlays here. So I just ran my Pretty Bubble Applicator again by pressing play. And I'm just going to scroll down here and select 15, press place. And I'm just gonna keep that as is. I really don't want to resize. I'm gonna press enter. Okay, I'm loving it. Let's go ahead and add one more. Okay, we're going to press play, scroll down, and this time I'm going to select 14, press place. Now I do want to move this one around, but not quite yet. I'm going to go ahead and place it by pressing enter. Okay, let me grab my move tool here at the top of my tools panel. Now that particular layer is still selected, so I can just click and kind of move that around here. I wanted these bubbles right here to be kind of right in front of baby's eyesight there. Okay, I really like that. Okay, so let's talk about something else real quickly. What happens when some of the bubbles are overlapping on your subject? Maybe the overlay is where you want it to be, but you just need to take some bubbles away. That is very easy to do as well. Now here you have your targeted bubble removal. Okay, first of all, let me find out. I have a layer here with, there's two bubbles on baby's arm. So if I'm not sure which one that is, I can just click on the little eyeball, okay, next to each layer. And once you see that particular bubble go away, you know it's on that particular overlay. So I'm seeing a bubble right here on baby's arm that I want to remove. There's another one, but that's not as big of a deal for me. Okay, so I have targeted bubble removal clicked. I'm going to click play. And it does say make sure your bubble layer is selected in the layers panel. We just did that. If it's not, press stop and retry again. So I'm going to select continue. Okay, and now you have the rest of your instructions. Press continue. Notice we have a layer mask here. When using layer masks, remember that black conceals and white reveals. Okay, so the action's already selected the brush for me, and black is already the foreground color. So again, black conceals, white reveals. So if I want to conceal this bubble, I'm just going to click on it. Also, make sure your brush opacity here at the top options bar is at 100%. So notice what happens when I click on that here. Okay, it's gone. Super easy, simple fix. And I can do that on any of the bubbles on that particular overlay. And you can move to another if you've stacked them on top of each other. Okay, so super, super simple to use. Guys, you can have so much fun with this collection. Thanks so much for taking a look at this special tutorial we put together for you guys.